Hey, everybody, welcome back to another episode of Chip Stock Investor that may not age well.
No, it may not age well, but we're here anyways to double click on some points about Onto Innovation.
Let's provide some color on our key points. In this episode, we're going to talk about how Onto has weathered the downturn and their revenue is actually back to all-time highs, as well as those beautiful profit margins. How did they pull that off? We'll also talk about the two acquisitions that they have made that's going to strengthen their product line and their service line. And finally, we'll discuss some notes on valuation.
Valuation notes. Can't wait to double click on those.
You can't use it more than once.
Oh, okay. Okay. No. What else? What cliche am I missing? Double click.
Color.
There's another one that you really love. That's enough analyst cliches.
Just as a reminder as to where Onto Innovation fits into the semiconductor industry flow, they fit into that big bubble down there in the center, wafer fab, packaging, and assembly equipment. Onto Innovation specializes in PDC and metrology, PDC process diagnostic and control equipment, and also they focus on lithography, which will come up later in this episode, in advanced packaging. They also have a leading software stack that makes it all work.
Let's take a look at our end market cycle for the semiconductor industry. As we've been talking about here for the last couple of months especially, we've seen a pretty wide divergence in different end market cycles. Accelerated computing and AI infrastructure for data centers, of course, still seemingly in max growth mode, and that is expected to last into 2025. If not, keep right on trucking into 2026. Consumer electronics and then cloud and enterprise, excluding accelerated compute infrastructure, still just struggling to break into the beginning of a new growth cycle. Auto and industrial, it seems that recovery has been delayed into 2025. Interestingly, though, about metrology, which Onto specializes in, metrology is a bit of a leading indicator for the semiconductor industry, because if you're going to start manufacturing new chips, or if you're expanding your chip fab, you need metrology equipment to make sure that your end product is actually coming off of the line and usable. So a lot of this metrology equipment tends to get sold ahead of a new growth cycle for the industry. So let's break this down. Let's start with Onto's earnings for Q3 2024, and then we'll talk about some of these end markets that Onto Innovation is enabling and maybe teeing up the next wave of growth for.
Here's the breakdown for year-over-year and quarter-over-quarter numbers for Onto. Onto has actually navigated the bear market quite well. They reached that all-time high in profitability again, which is actually ahead of our estimate. In this most recent quarter, they are back to over $250 million in revenue with net income over $55 million. You can see that's up significantly from the same time last year.
Mm-hmm. And do bear in mind, this is on a GAAP basis that we have highlighted, not an adjusted basis. So if you're looking for a highly profitable, smaller business that also turns a profit, Onto Innovation definitely checks those boxes.
Before we get to more exciting financial charts, let's talk about your money for just one moment and a word from our sponsor, public.com.
Here we are in the first week of November. Elections are finished in the United States. Interest rates are actually back up again after another sell-off in the bond market, which means if you've been looking to lock in an interest rate, a fixed income portion of your investment portfolio, it is still possible to land a 7% or roughly 7% annualized yield on a bond account from public.com. Pretty good stuff.
You have to act fast, though, because those yields aren't locked in until you invest. It's easy to open an account at public.com. Check it out in the link below in the description, public.com/CSI, and get your bond account open and that interest rate locked in. Let's jump back into Onto's financials. This chart going all the way back to January 2022. And as I mentioned, they did navigate this bear market quite well. But at the tail end of 2022, that was their last peak. And you can see they're back at it, $252 million in revenue, $1.07 per share on a diluted basis, and net income climbing back up. to 53 million.
Yeah, if we lop off the quarter that ended in December 2022 onto already very much back to all-time highs on an earnings per share basis and expected to just kind of continue on from here on out into 2025 and beyond, notching new all-time highs. And this is also the case for free cash flow. So they had a nice bump in recent quarters in their free cash flow as some of the investments they've been making the last couple of years have begun to pay off, investing in manufacturing capacity, meaning for Onto Innovation, their ability to actually make these machines that could ship to the chip fabs, the chip makers. So $59 million in free cash flow. Again, by all counts, this is a profitable business, highly profitable business, and getting a nice scale up of their profit margins as the revenue ramps back up.
All that free cash flow has padded their cash reserves. They have $855 million at the end of September 2024 in cash and cash equivalents. And this all leads us to point number two of our video about some of the acquisitions that Onto has made that go right in line with their current product line and help with its expansion.
So here's some of the products that they currently provide, specializing, of course, in metrology and PDC, process diagnostic and control. One of those pieces of equipment are used for HBM, high bandwidth memory, of course, used prolifically in NVIDIA and AMD's accelerated computing systems, chiplet architecture, which of course is a form of advanced packaging, and then specialty automotive and power applications, which is an area of the market, as we showed you earlier with our end market cycles, that continues to be down and is trying to find a bottom currently as we speak, perhaps a recovery delayed into next year. But let's talk about what Onto did, especially with this last row here, specialty automotive and power chips. Also within that advanced packaging row, the third row there, the very first piece of equipment that's shown, the jet step lithography equipment. We're going to circle back to that in just a moment. But first, let's talk about the specialty automotive and power. Of course, that's an area of the market that is currently bottoming, a recovery in power chips and automotive chips, not expected now until 2025, but Onto has gone shopping to strengthen this part of their portfolio. Let's talk about this first.
On the same day that Onto Innovation released their Q3 earnings results, they also announced that they acquired Lumina Instruments. Lumina is a small metrology business.
And specifically what this acquisition is for is raw or unpatterned wafers, especially for silicon carbide and gallium nitride, SiC and GaN wafers. Feeds right into that power, automotive, and industrial chips portion of the metrology business. What exactly would a wafer fab need metrology for on raw, unpatterned wafers? A wafer that's not ready to be diced up into chips yet? A few weeks ago, we did a video on Disco Core, a company that provides the saws and cutting tools and dicing tools for silicon wafers. And before they become a silicon wafer or a silicon carbide or GaN wafer, they go through this CZ method where the silicon is made into a boule. It gets melted in a big hot crucible. And when they get pulled out of this, this is what they look like. Think of it like a big log of salami. And then they get sliced into those wafers, which you often see people in lab suits holding onto in a fab somewhere. So at every step of this process, you need metrology tools to make sure that the wafers are the right diameter, the surface is smooth, there's no defects. So that's what those laser metrology machines are from Lumina Instruments.
In the metrology and PDC equipment market, there's the biggest player, KLA Corp, but these are some of the smaller players that you see here. Onto Innovation is the one we chose to focus on because it's a small cap company, but it's not so small. Some of these other competitors are pretty tiny. Mm-hmm. There's lots of different types of metrology, but Onto Innovation specifically focuses on that first one, optical metrology.
Yeah, they have some key technology that made them a standout when we originally purchased in early 2023. That's paid off. But there's this other segment, though, that really didn't get a lot of attention, including from us when we originally started covering this business, that earlier this summer we talked about. Here's where we get to double click on this. Let's talk about the lithography portion of the business.
So if you haven't seen it yet, we'll link a video here that we talked about Onto Innovation's lithography business and glass substrates. But at the same time that Onto announced that they acquired Lumina Instruments, they also acquired the lithography business from Kulik and Safa. I didn't even know that Kulik had a litho business.
I didn't either, but I guess we probably can't be faulted for that because Onto said that both Lumina and Kulik and Safa's litho business generate very little revenue. So it probably wasn't a meaningful part of Kulik's business anyways, for what it's worth.
Exactly. But for Onto, they said that this will accelerate and expand the JetStep panel lithography machine.
Mm-hmm. So we covered this in two parts earlier this summer. One specifically about Onto Innovations lithography equipment. And then second, a couple weeks later, TSMC, Taiwan Semi, actually purchased a fab in Taiwan that it seems will work on this stuff. But when we're looking at advanced packaging techniques, let's say 3 years down the road from now, it seems that a lot of companies, including TSMC, are looking at going the route of square panels when they package their chips instead of round wafers that pair up with the patterned wafer that they develop. There's a lot of reasons for this that we talk about in that video from earlier this summer. But when you're talking about all of these different 3D architectures, chiplets, stacking chips on top of each other, this is kind of where the industry is headed when we're talking about advanced semiconductors, advanced logic chips, accelerated computing systems, and such.
And when we're discussing advanced packaging substrates, this is what we're talking about. There's two graphics here we have from TSMC for two of their packaging processes. Both of these are chip on wafer on substrate with two different substrates. First one PCB, and the second one, another substrate, could be glass. Intel had this photo of a square glass wafer. This could be a real thing in 3 years. Intel's been working on it. Are they going to do anything with it?
It's hard to say at this point, but this is what it would look like. You know, these chips mounted on these square panels. It could be glass. It also could just be a more traditional substrate like silicon as well. Either way, the point is circles are on their way out. Squares are in. It's hip to be square. Who knows what Intel's going to do with it, but TSMC is definitely throwing some capital at this. So going back to that video this summer on TSMC, they talked about actually allocating some capital to fan-out level packaging, including glass panels. And then shortly after they outline their capital expenditures for the next year, they go out and they buy this LCD screen fab from Innolux in Taiwan. And Innolux had said that a lot of the equipment there can actually just be converted from making screens for devices for like your smartphone or your TV into packaging substrates, including glass. So interesting things happening here. Onto Innovation definitely seems like it's wanting in on this phase of R&D in support of TSMC and what they have planned.
There's a number of companies working on advanced packaging lithography equipment besides Onto Innovation. Of course, Applied Materials, a big player in this space, and Ushio and Canon. If you've been along with us from the start of this channel, we said maybe back in 2022 that the ASML litho advancements could be slowly ending. Advanced packaging will actually be what's leading the charge in semi-innovation.
Mm-hmm. And that doesn't mean that ASML is going to lose its relevance. It's just possibly that the actual wafer development using ASML's EUV equipment might just be slowing down a bit. So those machines are just so expensive, $300, $400 million a pop now for the high NA EUV machines. That price tag isn't going down anytime soon. So a lot of chip makers might just be looking for the next lowest hanging fruit. And it seems that advanced packaging is it. So Onto Innovation on the cusp of some really good things. And that's why they've returned to growth so quickly and back to all-time high revenues, GAAP net income, and free cash flow.
Let's move on to the third point of the video and talk about Onto Innovation's valuation. On a trailing basis, Onto Innovation now trades for 47x on earnings per share and 38x trailing 12-month free cash flow. That's a little bit more favorable now, probably due to that increase in free cash flow. And then on a forward-looking basis, price to earnings 27x and free cash flow around 27x as well. Onto is flush with cash, back in all-out growth mode, and it's leading advanced metrology and perhaps on the cusp of some really big breakthroughs in advanced packaging substrates like glass. And I think we really like this valuation.
Yeah, we've now purchased this stock a few times since we made the initial purchase in early 2023, when we were still, I guess at least the consensus was still that we were still in a bull market. And we are definitely inclined to do so again here for a fourth or fifth time. We'll sell off after the Q3 earnings update. I think a lot of that is probably just some caution surrounding not all of the semiconductor industry rebounding at the same time, especially in power chips. But we like those acquisitions though, the tuck-in acquisitions that they think will generate about $100 million in revenue within the next 3 years. That's a nice add-on that they probably didn't have to spend very much cash on, owing to the fact that both of those purchases, those small businesses, generate very little revenue now. So onto and able to plug them into their existing portfolio, actually go to market with them based on what they already have with their customers. And this is probably favorable for their profitability in the coming years as well. So a lot of good stuff happening at Onto Innovation. Like Casey said, some stuff happening in lithography as it pertains to advanced packaging and metrology, that nice leading indicator for semiconductor industry. If you think we're nearing the next growth cycle finally, other than accelerated computing and AI, this is one to take a close look at.
That's all for this episode of Chipstock Investor. Make sure you check out our Semiconductor Insider membership. Just $5 gets you a whole lot of benefits over on our Discord channel, including show notes, live Q&As weekly, and just generally great discussion and coverage on all of the companies that we watch.
That's where all of our content is these days. We can't make a video on all of it. So if you're looking for everything we research and take notes on, Semi Insider.
See you all again very soon.